नमस्कार, नई दिल्ली के विज्ञान भवन से मैं संजीव उपाध्याय आप सभी का हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूं। अब से कुछ ही देर में माननीय प्रधानमंत्री डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह राष्ट्रीय नव प्रवर्तन परिषद यानी नेशनल इनोवेशन काउंसिल की रिपोर्ट जनता को पेश करेंगे। ये परिषद की पहली रिपोर्ट है, नव प्रवर्तन इनोवेशन यानी नई शुरुआत और पहल की हर क्षेत्र में आवश्यकता है। नव प्रवर्तन 21वीं शताब्दी में समृद्धि और राष्ट्रीय प्रतिस्पर्धा का प्रेरक है। भारत सरकार ने 2010 से 2020 को नव प्रवर्तन दशक घोषित किया है और श्री सैम पिट्रोडा की अध्यक्षता में राष्ट्रीय नव प्रवर्तन परिषद का गठन किया गया है। आज जनता को रिपोर्ट पेश करते समय यहां विज्ञान भवन में संबद्ध मंत्रालयों के मंत्री, परिषद के सदस्य, देश विदेश से वरिष्ठ योजनाकार, वैज्ञानिक, उद्योग और शिक्षा जगत से गण्यमान्य व्यक्ति उपस्थित रहेंगे। नव प्रवर्तन भारतीय विरासत और परंपरा का एक अंग रहा है। शून्य और दशमलव की प्रणाली की खोज से लेकर एक प्राचीन सभ्यता का हमारा देश प्रमुख आश्रय रहा है। ये नालंदा और तक्षशिला जैसे प्रथम वैश्विक विश्वविद्यालय से लेकर वास्तुकला और इंजीनियरिंग के चमत्कारों का भी प्रवर्तक है। आगे बढ़ते हुए भारत ने कृषि, दूध उत्पादन, अंतरिक्ष, परमाणु ऊर्जा तथा दूर संचार में सफल कदम भी बढ़ाए हैं। भारत के लिए समावेशी नव प्रवर्तन नए मॉडल की आवश्यकता महसूस की गई है, जो पिरामिड की सतह के लोगों के लिए समाधान उपलब्ध करा सके। भारत को अधिक किफायती नव प्रवर्तन की आवश्यकता है, जो अधिक किफायती लागत पर उत्पाद और सेवाएं प्रस्तुत करे, जो निम्न आय स्तर के लोगों के लिए भी सुरक्षा, कार्यकुशलता और उत्पादों के उपयोग से समझौता किए बिना लाभप्रद हो। इस तरह की नई सोच और पहल राष्ट्रीय नव प्रवर्तन परिषद का मुख्य उद्देश्य है और लक्ष्य भी। काफी समय से महसूस किया जा रहा है कि देश के समाज के हर क्षेत्र में कुछ नया करने की जरूरत है। पुरानी प्रौद्योगिकी को नई सोच के साथ लोगों तक पहुंचाना बेहद आवश्यक है। माननीय प्रधानमंत्री डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह विज्ञान भवन में पधार रहे हैं और उनके साथ हैं परिषद के अध्यक्ष श्री सैम पिट्रोडा।
Honorable Prime Minister, Honorable Finance Minister, Honorable Minister of Micro Small Enterprises, Honorable Minister of Human Resource Development and IT, Honorable Deputy Chairman of the Planning Commission, Member Secretary National Innovation Council, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. On behalf of the National Innovation Council, I welcome you all to this function for the release of the National Innovation Council's first report to the people. It is a report to the people because we believe people innovate. I thank the Honorable Prime Minister and his Cabinet colleagues for their presence. Innovation is required for growth, employment, prosperity, competitiveness and problem solving. It is now on everyone's agenda. World over, companies and countries are focused on innovation. India has had a long tradition of innovations and knowledge. In our old universities like Nalanda, Takshashila, we invented zero. We have traditions in astronomy, architect, and a lot of good work related to innovation is already going on in the country, by the people, for the people. Now that we are growing at 8%, and now that we are a country of a connected billion, it is more important for us to begin to think differently and come up with new ways of doing things with a different mindset to expedite the process of modernization. In addition, internet, web, and IT technologies have essentially changed everything we do. It has changed business models, processes, delivery of public services, governance, and has far-reaching implications on our future. Government of India decided to declare 2010-2020 as the decade of innovation. Prime Minister decided to set up a National Innovation Council consisting of 16-17 distinguished citizens, and we as a group met several times and collectively agreed to focus on five aspects of innovations. One, we said it has to be a platform which goes beyond R&D, science and technology laboratories, and reaches out to many other areas like education, health, governance. Then we said we ought to focus on inclusive growth, bottom of the pyramid, problems of the poor, with real understanding of affordability, sustainability, scalability. We also need to create better ecosystem for innovation with venture capital, private equity, intellectual property understanding. In the process, we are defining drivers for innovation, such as we would work more on durable products as opposed to disposable products. And we definitely need discourse on innovation so we can begin to question many things we do today. Today, we are presenting a report to the people on our first year of existence. In the first year, we have developed a framework to finance innovations for the bottom of the pyramid through creation of India Inclusive Innovation Fund, and we have been working with the Finance Ministry to organize that. Similarly, we are working on clusters. We have 150 industry clusters, and we want to seed innovations in these clusters, and we are working with micro, small, and medium enterprises on that. We are also nurturing innovations in the education system through actions in school, colleges, intervening in curriculum, talent spotting, innovation among students, awards, creation of Meta University, and innovation ecosystem at the universities. And we are working with Ministry of HRD on many of these challenges. Similarly, we are working with the Planning Commission to give input into the 12th plan. We are working with the state governments to help create state innovation councils, ministries to work on sectorial councils. And overall, the idea is to really create ecosystem in the country to foster innovation. To support the drudgeries of our working class, we have a special program to look at how we can promote innovations in the working class, artisans, craftspeople. We want to promote and share knowledge with our counterparts and global experts. For this, we have had a meeting yesterday all day on Global Innovation Roundtable We have distinguished leaders from 15 different countries. They are all here, and I want to welcome them specially. I must say that the UPA government, from my perspective, has been very innovative. National Knowledge Commission was an innovation, RTI is an innovation, NAREGA, all of these initiatives are quite unique. Unfortunately, many times we don't get credit for it. National Knowledge Network, which will connect 1500 nodes with 40 gigabit bandwidth to connect all our universities, all our R&D institutions, is a classical example of government's commitment to build right kind of infrastructure. This network is already operational with 500 nodes, and it is really built to improve collaborations between research scientists, academicians, and our industry. Similarly, we will be connecting 250,000 panchayats to optical fiber with broadband connectivity and create various platforms for UID, GIS, applications, payment, procurement, portals. And this, in an open environment, will create transparency, accountability, and allow us to do things differently in education, health, agriculture, governance, research, business, trade. In all of these, the key is to democratize information. We want to spend a fair amount of investment in creating public information infrastructure to democratize information. We want Indian model of development, model that really addresses the problems of the poor. We want local talent, local language considerations, local solutions, and involvement of the local communities. I have been saying for the last 25 years that the best brains in the world are busy solving problems of the rich, who really don't have problems to solve. And as a result, problems of the poor really need a lot more talent. We have the largest number of poor, and we have a great deal of talent. And I believe we have moral responsibility to address the problems of the poor. We have to make sure the solutions are affordable and scalable. We have to keep our nose on the ground to look at the problems of the poor, bottom of the pyramid. At the end, we need to focus on disparity between rich and poor, urban, rural, educated, uneducated. We got to understand that we have 550 million young below age of 25. It is their future, their education, their jobs that we need to really innovate for. We need massive changes and not incremental changes. It is a long journey which will take a lot more time. I remember when we started our journey in telecom, everyone used to criticize us. 20 years down the road, we are a nation of a connected billion. Innovation will also take a fair amount of time and energy. I hope that our young would work with us to innovate for our needs, to meet our challenges, and really help us redesign India's future. In the process, I hope we will help redesign the world. However, this would require a lot of collaboration, lot of cooperation, community involvement, commitment, courage, and clarity. I'm happy to say that our government is committed to innovation, committed to this journey, and I'm thankful to the Prime Minister and his cabinet colleagues for all the support they have given us. Thank you. Now I would request Honorable Finance Minister to say a few words.
Honorable Prime Minister, my distinguished cabinet colleagues, Sri Sam Petroda, Dr. Mantik Singh Ahluwalia, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's indeed a privilege for me to be present on this happy occasion of the release of the report of the first year of National Innovation Council. Union Cabinet had declared 2010 to 2020 as the decade of innovation and set up the Innovation Council under Sri Sam Petroda. I would like to congratulate the Innovation Council for getting down to work in right earnest and taking steps towards evolving an Indian model of innovation to address our concerns and emerging challenges. Innovation, whether as knowledge creation or as knowledge application, has always been a major source of competitive advantage, wealth creation, and improvement in the quality of life. However, the urge to innovate or to adopt process that encourages innovation is not universal. Some societies or some sectors within the same society are better at innovation and innovating their products and process to their larger benefit than many others. This is also true about us. While we have to our credit, I am not going back to the history. Sri Petroda has already referred to some of the momentous innovation, but in the contemporary period, we have to our credit some recent innovations like an interocular lens at 1/10 of the global costs, a heart operation at a 1/6 of the global cost, and a car just at over ₹1 lakh. There are large segments of the society that could benefit from innovation-led productivity improvements for higher incomes and well-being. Our informal sector, where the majority of our workforce is employed, is beset with low productivity and low skill activities. Our craftspersons, weavers, small businessmen could all benefit from innovation if we could exploit even the existing knowledge base in improving their product designs, packaging, and connectivity with markets. Indeed, there is an enormous amount of extant global knowledge that can be tapped and harnessed to improve the performance of our economy and the lives of our people. I am given to understand that the National Innovation Council has already begun work in seeding innovation into the industry clusters. Sustaining India's growth momentum is critically dependent on improving our factor productivity through technological innovations and process re-engineering. It is also dependent on enhancing the capability of our young population and workforce to understand new technology and absorb and stimulate it to meet the local needs. In that context, there are at least three areas that we need to focus on. First area is education and knowledge creation. Second area is creating and strengthening of a competitive environment to support private enterprise. The third area is to encourage a greater focus on research and design activities in our enterprises and in institutions of higher learning. We are making progress in all these areas, though perhaps not at the pace we would like to have. Education is what nurtures creativity and spurs innovation. Our education system needs to revamp to promote talented students. This is being pursued. We have introduced several scholarship schemes to promote young talent in recent years. I am happy to learn that a scheme for innovative scholarship is being considered by the Ministry of Human Resource Development. At the behest of Sri Pitroda, the government allocated ₹1200 crore for a national knowledge network to connect all major knowledge institutions so that interdisciplinary conversations could begin between faculty and students. I understand that the network has already connected over 404 institutions and another 600 are on the way. This initiative will be complemented by connectivity to all colleges by the Ministry of Human Resource Development. Building on this national network, knowledge network, I am told that India plans to roll out world's first meta-university based on multidisciplinary and collaborative learning from the academic year 2012. We have made creation of capital stock in education as an infrastructure sector and made it eligible for viability gap funding under the public-private partnership initiatives from the current financial year. Further, with the setting up of the National Skill Development Council, the government delivery mechanism in skill development and training has been significantly innovated. These steps should help address some of our concerns with the help of the private sector in the area of education and skill upgradation. Economic reforms since 1991 have sought to create and strengthen a competitive environment of our enterprises. Though we have come a long way, and this is apparent in our growth momentum and the resilience in our economy in recent years, it is an ongoing process that needs to be nurtured. The government has created a number of public programs supporting innovation and encouraging a greater attention to research and development. These outcomes from the initiatives could be improved to meet our needs. A new approach is needed, where the government's role should increasingly be to provide a policy and regulatory framework that encourages the private sector to undertake innovation. In this, I would like to mention government has already enhanced the weightage reduction on payments made by the national laboratories, universities and institutions of technology for scientific research to 175% last year and further to 200% in the current fiscal. National Innovation Council has now made a proposal to set up an India Inclusive Innovation Fund. Venture capital does not get attracted to solving the problems of the bottom half of the population. Our government is committed to give them their due opportunities. With the permission of the Prime Minister, I propose to make an initial contribution of ₹100 crore to kickstart the fund and call upon the universities to participate in this unique effort to combine economic returns with social returns. I expect that India Inclusive Innovation Fund to be a global leader in pioneering low-cost innovations. Let me conclude by suggesting that innovation and technical progress is a result of a complex set of relationships among the actors that include private enterprises, universities, public research institutions, and the discerning consumers. We must all work together for creating a culture of innovation and its useful applications for the larger goal. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for the patience.
May I now request Honorable Prime Minister to release the report. I am also going to request Honorable Prime Minister to launch the India Innovation Portal. We have a switch for you, sir. You just have to push it. Everything else is automatic. Thank you. This portal is all about information repository on innovations across sectors for various users for various innovation needs. It's a platform to connect and collaborate through innovation communities. Thank you, sir. May I now request, sir? I'll come with you.
My cabinet colleagues, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, Shri Veer Bhadra Singh Ji, Shri Kapil Sibal, Shri Montek Singh Ahluwalia, Dr. Sam Pitroda, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I am very happy to participate in this unique function which marks 1 year of solid work by the National Innovation Council. This council has very eminent men and women as its members, and I thank each one of them for their contribution during the past 1 year or so. The report to the people just released today contains a summary of the Council's activities during this period of 1 year, and it's a matter of satisfaction for all of us that the progress achieved so far has been very good. As you are aware, in the year 2009, our government declared its intent to make the next decade a decade of innovation. This is because we realized that innovation has a critical role to play in the processes of India's economic and social growth and development. The sets of challenges that we as a nation face is not only diverse, but in some ways also unique. It is only through creativity and innovation, by coming up with novel solutions appropriate to the Indian conditions and Indian context, that we can meet these challenges effectively. Indeed, we see innovation as truly a game changer to move from incremental change to radical change. And therefore, it is our resolve to build an enabling environment for innovation to flourish in our country. There are some advantages that we have in achieving the task that we have set for ourselves. Our democracy, our diversity, and our demography are all facilitating factors which encourage innovation in our country. Our democracy, which has been deepening through panchayats and broadening through civil society action, gives an opportunity to multiply, to multiple thoughts to contend with each other. Our diversity is an advantage, as there is evidence that innovation happens when people with diverse talents engage in a common endeavor. And demographically, we are also a very youthful nation. The young people are restless. They are impatient for change, and they are innovative. We need to fully exploit these enormous advantages that we have as a nation. Our legacy of innovation goes a long way back. As Sam mentioned, we were the first to realize the vision of universities at Nalanda and Takshila. Our freedom struggle that we won without recourse to arms was a social innovation in peaceful resistance. In recent times, we have made several innovations in areas such as space technology, atomic energy, and automobiles. But innovation in our country has by and large focused mostly on the needs of the upper income groups, not adequately on solving the problems of the poor and the underprivileged. We wish, as we must, change this state of affairs. We would like to pioneer a model of innovation that addresses problems in areas such as poverty eradication, people's health, rural communications, development of agriculture, development of animal husbandry, green energy, and similar other challenges. We are currently witnessing an innovative experiment in right-based delivery through a right to work, right to education, and right to information, while a right to food security is on the anvil. I have been told that in the first year of its work, the National Innovation Council has focused on nurturing a culture of innovation through education. It has built on the earlier work of the National Knowledge Commission towards creating a national knowledge network which would ultimately connect all colleges in our country. It also proposes to launch a meta-university which would provide a student the opportunity to pursue another discipline of study in another college that is part of the network. This would enable a student of astrophysics in the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, for example, to take up a course in comparative literature at the Jadavpur University. Such creative reconfigurations are expected to create new minds conducive to the growth of innovation. A number of other initiatives have also been taken. The Ministry of Human Resource Development, under the leadership of Kapil Sibal, proposes to introduce innovation fellowships to reward talent at the school level. It also proposes to engage students at high school level to map local history, ecology, and local cultural heritage to make them critically conscious of their immediate surrounding environment. Similarly, to increase competitiveness of local small-scale industry, the National Innovation Council, together with the Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, and with the assistance of CSIR, is setting up industry innovation clusters. Two university clusters have signed in for setting up courses in innovation, the University of Delhi and recently the MS University of Baroda. To promote innovation, the 13th Finance Commission has provided a 1 crore grant to each district called the District Innovation Fund. State level innovation councils have been set up to complement activities of the National Council. The Prasar Bharati has taken a decision to champion local innovations and local heroes of innovation. In addition, they will be showcasing India's legacy of creative, innovative thought and our major innovations in the contemporary India. With these words, I would like to compliment Sam and his team at the National Innovation Council for these steps. I also wish to thank my cabinet colleagues, particularly Shri Pranab Mukherjee, for extending their wholehearted support to these new pioneering initiatives. I wish the National Innovation Council all success in the noble work it is engaged in. I thank you.
Honorable Prime Minister, dignitaries on the dais, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the close of this morning's function. We take this occasion to convey our sincere gratitude to the Honorable Prime Minister for his visionary leadership in conceptualizing and setting up the National Innovation Council. It has given us a unique opportunity to mobilize the country's talent to develop an Indian model of innovation, learning from our own legacy and from best practices around the world. True to his vision of creating an interconnected society, an interconnected knowledge-sharing society, the Cabinet has approved connecting nearly 250,000 panchayats, and we hope to complete this work in 24 months, which holds tremendous potential to connect a billion minds and radicalize our democracy as never before. We owe a very special gratitude to the Finance Minister, who has played a stellar role in supporting the suggestions that we have put forward. It took him exactly 30 minutes to clear our proposal on the National Knowledge Network. We are the first country to connect all our knowledge institutions for collaborative and multidisciplinary learning. We are happy to inform you, sir, that we have already connected 440 knowledge institutions who are at this point in time watching this program on a webcast. We promise you, sir, that by this time next year, when we present our report, over 1,500 institutions would have been connected. We consider the HR, the Human Resource Development Minister, Mr. Sibal, a leader to the innovation movement in this country, impatient with the legacy and always daring and dreaming about change. He has always stood by us and supported all our ideas that he felt worthwhile. He has always been a source of inspiration. We are working very closely with him and his team of officials on the proposals submitted, and many will roll out in the academic year 2012. Similarly, the Minister of MSME has extended all help and cooperation in our effort at developing innovation clusters. Without his invaluable help, we would not have been able to commence this work. A very sincere thank you to you, sir. Deputy Chairman Planning Commission has always encouraged lateral thinking and has been a consistent champion of innovation. The evidence is that for the first time, the 12th plan will have a chapter on innovation. All members of the Commission have been extremely supportive. Special thanks is also due to the Member Secretary of the Planning Commission, who has gone out of her way to iron out our problems whenever we encountered any. We thank all our invitees were very graciously accepting our invitation, and invitees from the media for being here. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. May I request you to move to the atrium for a cup of tea and request the media to join us in hall number 3 for an interaction. But do kindly be on your seats until the Prime Minister has left the auditorium. Thank you very much.
कुछ नया करने के लिए नई सोच और पहल पहली शर्त है। राष्ट्रीय नव प्रवर्तन परिषद से राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर पहल हो चुकी है और उसकी रिपोर्ट भी जनता को पेश की जा चुकी है। सबके साथ मिलकर नए दौर में नई कहानी लिखने की शुरुआत हो गई है। धन्यवाद, नमस्कार। Thank you.